Mr. Ambassador, a couple of days ago, you said that claims of an imminent invasion of Ukraine by the Russians are nonsense, baseless, and paranoid. Do you still think that?
Absolutely. I think recently we have determined the exact date of our invasion together with my colleague diplomats here in New York. It is the 30th of February. I think you can mark this date in your calendar, if you find it, of course.
If that is the case, what is the point of 150,000 troops on the Ukrainian border? What are they doing there?
First of all, who counted them? Where do you take this figure, 150,000? I remember it was 100,000, then it was 120,000, now it is 150,000. Some people say 190,000. So I admit inflation is very high here in New York. We see it on the prices, but in the number of soldiers...
I think it's inflation demonstrated by satellite pictures, which we have seen. And unless the Russia is now putting in cardboard tanks, there are troops there.
Well, we don't trust the US and British intelligence. They let us down the whole world on many occasions, enough to remember weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. But in any case, you asked about what are the troops doing there. Well, they are on our territory. They are not placed on the border immediately. They are placed in their places where they usually are, on the border.
Would you be as relaxed if it were the other way around and Ukraine had moved, let's say that the Ukrainians had 50,000 troops and they moved to within a kilometer of the Russian border? Would you be as relaxed about it as you are?
We are not relaxed, and you are very close to the truth, because Ukrainians have 120,000 on the line of contact with Donbas, and they started shelling Donbas yesterday. That's why, of course, we are not relaxed.
Are you now accusing the Ukrainians of aggression?
I'm not accusing them of aggression. I am accusing them of shelling peaceful population in Donbas, and this is quite obvious, given it's not about from the satellites, but it's from the people there, from the eyewitnesses. I think that the OSCE monitoring mission also made this in today's report, as far as I was informed. So this is a fact of life. Whether it's aggression or not, difficult to say. But when you have 120,000 troops in full capacity to strike at the border, at the line of contact, actually, I think you have to be preoccupied and you have to think about aggression. It's not Russian troops on Russian territory.
All right, well, look, we can trade numbers. But one thing that we are absolutely certain about is that Mr. Putin has said that he is going to conduct nuclear drills and he will oversee them himself. Isn't that a rather dangerous escalation of the situation which you yourself have just been describing as a tense one?
I don't think that everybody should tell us when we should or shouldn't conduct drills. Our drills happened before. We announced a number of drills beforehand. By the way, these in Belarus that also went in the center of attention were announced months ago, and they are now being presented as a kind of Russian alleged escalation. This is not true. I don't think that our drills on our territory should worry anyone.
Yes, but Mr. Putin is a smart man. He must know that in the context, announcing a nuclear drill, isn't going to reduce the tensions, is it?
Well, if you have nuclear weapons, of course, you need to keep it in good shape. So drills are necessary from time to time. I'm not responsible for this question. Of course, I can't speak for my president in this regard. I'm sure that he had good reasons to announce these drills. There are a lot of issues. I think that the world should be preoccupied more than our drills on our territory. So I'm really very much not understanding what is the point of being too preoccupied there.
Some Western commentators are saying that what is actually happening is that Mr. Putin didn't anticipate the Western resolve that he would have to face in the form of NATO and European unity, given the buildup of troops on the Ukraine border. Has he misjudged the situation?
I would say that there are a lot of things for the world to be preoccupied right now, and you shouldn't judge it in terms of chessboard, in terms of geopolitical struggle. I think we made quite clear that we have absolutely legitimate concerns about our security, which is being affected by NATO placement of infrastructure and troops near our border. And we have the right to be concerned. So we made concrete proposals. These proposals are long overdue. It's not the first time that we voice our preoccupations. I think we did it for tens of years already. We base our preoccupations on the provisions of basic OSCE documents of Russian NATO Act and also on some promises which Western leaders have given us. So this is quite logical. And I think what people, what peace-loving people in Europe should be preoccupied is really to stop the militaristic tune that is now in the heads of many, many Western politicians, unfortunately, and to get to negotiating table and to see what we can together do in terms of security for guaranteeing Russia's absolutely legitimate concerns.
Well, can I just put lastly another reading of this situation to you, which is this, that Mr. Putin is rather enjoying this, that he has Western leaders coming to his table. He has a Western media talking about him, as we are doing now, and that actually the eyes of the world are on this situation, and indeed the eyes of the Russian people are on this situation, diverting them from Russia's own economic problems.
I think that enjoying is not the right word that you can use in these circumstances when we see absolutely lack of responsibility from on behalf of Western leaders right now, and a lot of scaremongering and warmongering. So I don't know anybody who is enjoying this situation in Russia. And what you said about Russia's economic difficulties, well, every country has economic difficulties. I assume UK also has some after the Brexit as well. There is a trend that people say that the problems are narrowed down to Ukraine and to solving this artificial crisis around Ukraine with alleged Russian in Russian plans to attack. But I want to tell you that the picture is much bigger and Ukraine is only one piece of this puzzle. And that was exactly, I assume personally, that it was exactly the tactics of our Western partners to start all this hype when we informed them about our proposal and when we sent to them draft treaties with US and NATO about European security. This is a very strange coincidence, isn't it?
Ambassador, thank you very much indeed for your time this morning.
Thank you.